the first panel that we are doing on outdoor, because last 3 months there was not much to talk on outdoor, because all of us were locked inside our homes, and but now with the lockdown 5.0, a lot of restrictions have been eased and a lot of us are going out. And that is why we have given this the topic outdoor advertising going into reboot mode. So I have a very, very esteemed panel with me today. I'm going to introduce them in, I mean, I think this is in alphabetical order. All of you are equally important to us. So I have Ms. Anjali Krishnan, Head of Media Mondelez India. I have Ms. Anisha Agarwal, Country Media Leader, IKEA India. Mr. Atul Srivastav, Group CEO, Laksh Media Group. Mr. Harish Nayak, Group MD, Posterscope South Asia and President, Posterscope APAC. Mr. Jayesh Yagnik, CEO, Moms Outdoor Media Solutions. And Mr. Rishabh Mehta, Founder and CEO, Lokar Private Limited. Welcome all of you to the panel. And thank you so much for taking out time for us. I want to start this panel on a positive note. We all know that outdoor was one of the worst hit sector during the lockdown period. But now that people are already, there's movement, you go out, you, Delhi and Bombay are already, some parts of Delhi and Bombay are already reporting traffic jams. Rural is by and large open. So what is the future, and where do you see the recovery? If I can start with Mr. Srivastav or Mr. Nayak, either one of you can answer this question. Or Mr. Srivastav can start.
Okay. See, Nazia, I'll consider this as a typical 2020 match wherein we have lost 5 overs because of the rains. But game is yet to begin and 15 overs are still left. So definitely we have lost one full quarter wherein almost we could achieve only 20% of what billings we normally do in the Q1. So in Laksh definitely around 20% of billing we could achieve. We are going to touch that by the end of this quarter. But we are very, very hopeful, very positive about the remaining months. July onwards, we can see that occupancy will be in the range of 35 to 40%, or it may even touch 50% also. And after that, Diwali season and festival season is there, wherein we are very confident that this Diwali is going to be one of the best Diwali in last 10 years. And since most of the clients have not spent their budget, and various other mediums like budgets from events are not going to be spent so much. Budgets on print media, definitely some of the clients have spoken to us and they have indicated they are not going to be very aggressive on print media. Cinema will not be that important for at least for next 3-4 months. So I am assuming that all these advantages, IPL is not going to be there. Still clarity is not there. So all these factors are going to help outdoor. All these budgets may not be 100%, maybe 20%, maybe 50% of these budgets, but some amount will definitely come to outdoor, which is going to help the industry.
Harish, you want to add to it?
I think our view has been on a very positive side. I mean, internally, we all are very, very happy with whatever the situation. I think positivity is very, very important to look at any problem areas. For us, luckily, being a global leader in the business, access to information was there, and we were able to actually foresight. We spoke to our colleagues in China and a couple of other countries and anticipated, what are the challenges ahead. And I think we were able to plan our first 60 days, first 30, 35 days we had roughly around about...
Sorry, I'm interrupting. If you can tell us, what were these challenges? I mean, what did you learn from the China market?
Yeah, so obviously coming to the challenges is basically, look at the slowdown, there will be total closure, people won't go, and the impact on the out-of-home industry will be the highest. But the important thing, important learning which came out was how do you handle these 3 months of gap and how do you still stride forward was a big learning which came out. Obviously, we all know the financial challenges, the emotional, mental challenges, and the pressures which will come internally as well as externally. So, obviously, those were the big challenges. But I think internally, we looked at these 4 or 5 challenges and we thought that it is, as you have rightly worded, rebooting ourselves. So, for 30-35 days, we spent a lot of time on training ourselves because the new normal is going to be where 3 or 4 months, all the clients are going to have video meetings and all. So, how do you prepare yourself? What is the voice modulation? What are the ways of presenting yourself on a video? So, a lot of such areas we looked into. In fact, if you look at the work which we've done, both in terms of getting our backend right. So, a lot of focus was there on backend, be it creating newer services for our clients, where we invented a lot of new services, be it post-COVID office opening solutions to CSR, a lot of CSR work which we did, a lot of work which we were able to pull it off because of our access, be it in the out-of-home space or in the rural marketing space. We looked at green zones and we reached out to clients. And we looked at, whether we can do some activity. So, we've been doing some or the other work for last 15-20 days now. Obviously challenges will come, but I think the session which talks about how do you reboot yourself and how do you look at positivity and how do you overcome challenges is what we've really looked into and worked upon in last 60 days.
Mr. Shah, do you want to add to it? Mr. Shah there? Oh, sorry, Mr. Mehta. So sorry.
I was wondering who Mr. Shah was.
Sorry, I'm really sorry. Mr. Mehta.
Yeah, so I think I completely agree with both Atul and Resh in terms of the positivity and the way we are looking at moving forward post continuation of the COVID era. I think the major positive or the rather a silver lining that has been is the transition to digital. That transition has been pretty fast, and I think now all stakeholders really realize the importance of going digital, realize the importance of using technology, whether it's a media owner, agency or a brand. Over the last 30 to 45 days, we've had some very encouraging and interesting talks with all the stakeholders, and we've in the process rolled out very interesting things on the, say for example, just to share some insights on our planning tool. We incorporated the COVID APIs, where we now instantly all stakeholders can visualize where are the green areas and what are the opportunities for them to pick up sites which are in green areas and do their planning, look at more digital out of home as well, because in these current times there are societies which are open where since everybody is working from home, it's important to look at new touch points.
We have an entire section on that, but yes. If you want to speak about it now, you can.
Sure. So I think it's been great for us because what we've been trying to do over the last four and a half years in terms of bringing in more transparency, getting people to use more digital technologies, that's really playing through now. And we've also at the same time rolled out in a couple of other markets where things are slightly better. So we rolled out in Latin America as of last week and in Southeast Asia in a couple of countries as well. So things are improving. We are very positive that in India as well, we will hit back fairly strong over the next 2 quarters. FMCG has already seen pretty much near comeback level in terms of pre-COVID and situations now. So I think things are only going to go better. Healthcare is another sector which is really looking up. BFSI, again, they would look up. So I think overall, we are very positive that over the next quarter or so, the jump is going to be back to normal or even bigger.
Let's hope it goes the way you are saying. Even before I announce that we are inviting questions from audiences, I've already got 5 questions. We are live on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. Please keep sending your questions so that I can put them to these panelists and get you your answers. I want to now move to Jayesh, and I want to understand from you, considering that the market has started to open and we'll have people going brands advertise again, which are the categories you think are going to be the first ones to go back to outdoor?
Well, first of all, thank you so much, Nazia, for having me here. Extremely delighted to share virtual space with all these dignitaries here. Guys, thank you so much. Before I could start on the questions about the categories, which we'll start seeing back on this, let me, you know, just give you a simple example. We all are using devices. We all are using different kind of devices. You know, we use laptop, we use tablets, we use smartphones, and so on and so forth. There are a number of devices these days, and after being at home, we are finding it even more. Mm-hmm. We all have some point or the other encountered some kind of a problem with this device. Sometimes it gets slow, sometimes it gets stuck, sometimes it starts behaving extremely weird without any reason and all that. And, you know, the best thing any IT person would give you advice is to restart or reboot the device. And once you do that, you know, it definitely starts working much, much better in terms of the performance. And, you know, we get a better result as far as that is concerned. So I really love the topic what you have put, that rebooting of outdoor. And once the rebooting mode is done, it's going to be better. It's going to definitely bounce back. We're going to see the spring movement out here. And coming on to the question, Nazia, as far as the categories are concerned, what I personally feel is FMCG essential, which is one category which obviously has been doing quite well in terms of their sales also in past couple of months, and they are doing it and they will keep doing it. There is another category within FMCG, which is a personal hygiene or a hygiene if we want to talk about, which is slowly and steadily growing quite well. So this has hand sanitizers, this has liquid soaps, this has disinfecting surface sprays and things like that. So this is one category which I feel, and I'm personally working on 2 of the briefs on such categories. So I know it, you know, people are planning to launch it in a big way, and I'm talking about big corporate houses. So this is one new thing where people are looking, people are seeing the opportunities, and they would definitely try and explore that. So that is as far as the FMCG is concerned. Second thing, personally, what I think is automobile. And when I say automobile, especially two-wheelers and entry segment small cars would see traction in their sales, and hence they would need the need of advertising, mainly because of, again, the hygiene reason. At least for some time now, people will try and avoid public transport as far as possible. People who is having, I mean, someone who is having a cycle will try and graduate himself to a gearless motorcycle or a motorcycle or a bike or and so forth. People who are with bike will try and graduate themselves to a hatchback sedan, an entry-level car. So I'm not saying about luxury and all, but at least the entry-level car and two-wheeler in automobile is something which I feel should do well post this. And we have started seeing traction in this and automobile.
How about OTT, which was traditionally used to advertise a lot on OTT? And it's doing pretty well. It has done amazingly well in last 3 months.
It's doing pretty well, and to keep the momentum, it might. I'm not sure about the OTT, how they are pursuing themselves. But since the new content on television is down right now, news is the only fresh content which is going on. And hence, even the people who are habitual to television consumption are shifted to OTT. So we need to see once the lockdown is lifted and the shootings have already been started, both in terms of fiction, non-fiction. Once all that gets into the picture, how the graph of OTT consumption be.
Okay. But they despite of doing well, they have to compete amongst each other, right? So exactly. They have to advertise.
Exactly. And few of the categories like building repair, waterproofing, cements and all that, which is there, which have a season right now, which should do well. And as I think Atul was mentioning, BFSI. And when I say BFSI, I predominantly say banking, because of the new RBI thing wherein banks wants to give more and more loan to the consumer, and insurance. We all have seen how on other media also the advertising of insurance have gone quite high. So because of the kind of fear which is, you know, everyone is right now into. So these are the two more category, or BFSI is the one category, but there's a banking and insurance are the player which should go high according to me.
Anjali and Anisha and I would want you to be bring you into the debate. You are brands. Anjali, you think you would want to advertise on OTT, on outdoor right now? And you usually do it. I mean, during Raksha Bandhan and the entire festive season, you're very visible on outdoor. So what is the stand that you've taken right now on outdoor?
So first of all, Nazia, thank you for having me on the panel. I think in context of what categories that I see, you know, will get first to outdoor, I think is more from the emerging trends that you're seeing currently in the market, right? So there's a lot of chatter about self-care and, you know, health and wellness. I'm saying some of those categories are definitely going to go on to outdoor first. And then anything to do around immunity building, you know, security for yourself, financial, all of that is going to see a resurgence. And of course, like us, lots of other advertisers come on to out of home when there is the festive season. Starting off with Rakhi and then subsequently moving on to Diwali and into the next year, into Valentine's Day, which are big opportunities of growth, especially for the gifting category, which is where we operate. So definitely looking forward to that. I think it will probably not be quite the same that it used to be in the past, because there are still areas which are, you know, experiencing maybe constrained environments in which they're operating. So there isn't a complete lift, you know, in all your essential services. Malls are not operating, you know, people are still not going out that much. Slowly, yes, I think that should start picking up. And festive season is an opportunity, especially for brands like us, because we are actually, as Cadbury's, we are the makers and markers of happiness. So there's a lot of positivity around our brands. And it's an excellent opportunity when people are sort of coming out of a constrained environment to be there in out of home, because it's an opportunity to re-celebrate life in that sense, you know, and feel a little less depressed about the months that have gone by in the past. So, yes, I do see, the festive season, see a resurgence in out of home. For sure, but maybe not like, you know, in the same way it was before. It might go first to the green zones and the amber zones, and, you know, the red containment areas would continue to still be restricted. So maybe not there, but eventually that will also ease up.
If you were to give a percentage of how much drop you may see this year in your advertising on outdoor?
I think for festive season, if things go back to normalcy, I don't see any drop happening. The drop would be completely dependent on how the environment starts to evolve going forward, right? So I don't think any advertiser today has a complete fix on how the environment is going to shape up in the future. No one can say whether there will be another lockdown at some point in time, or things are going to open up and it is going to be fine. But if everything is fine and everything starts reaching a stage of completely normal living, then I don't see any drop happening in advertising spends.
Anisha, what's your view on this?
Hey, thank you all for having me. So, you know, I kind of echo what Anjali also says, but looking at the brand that we're not an essential. But surprisingly, the way we are seeing response, especially on our own platforms, we are very proud to own the space of home. We can proudly say that we can talk about home all the time and say that we can develop solutions and options for you when you're home. When it comes to out of home, it has been our best friend pre-COVID. And we've seen it all of Hyderabad. We've seen it how we launched, and we are a small brand right now in the country as vast as this. But Out of Home has held our hand to drive visitation, and we can attribute a lot of visitation percentage to this media as such. So there is a pre-COVID and a post-COVID scenario. And for me, it's not rebooting. For me, it's Out of Home 2.0. For me, it's reinventing. And that's what will be an expectation as a brand. Because I don't see this channel dissolving or having less equity in the market, because it will revive back. It will bounce, as Jayesh also rightly pointed, it will bounce. But how we bounce, when do we talk to people, how do we talk to people, what are our new touch points, is Out of Home really out of home for me, or is it out of my balcony? What do I see outside my balcony is out of home for me. What do I see when I sit in my car is out of home for me. So my touch points are going to change. My entire influence of brands has to be as close as my doorstep delivery. So the entire definition, you know, it's going to have to be evolved. And I see that this channel plays a very big role now. In fact, larger than before. We have a bigger responsibility on our shoulders to evolve this channel, and to not have innovation as something which is an add-on always. This is what I'm going to do, and then we have one innovation. We've got to move away from that. Innovation has to be part of the bucket. Only then can brands will start considering them Out of Home as a part and parcel the way it has always been. Because none of us stopped advertising. We were on all possible medias. We participated like we could. Even when we were non-essentials, we spoke about inspiration. We spoke about values. We spoke about living together at home. We got home at the center of everything, but not through Out of Home. So how do I, you know, how do I still have the same message and bring back Out of Home as a channel? Is the expectation, and the yes, the agency partners and everybody is partnering us to build that together. But yes, in the short run, my simple answer would be yes, we go on TV and digital. But in medium to long term, I see that Out of Home will be the channel which will be the emerging star, because people will move out.
Yeah, we all eventually would want to. I mean, we all already want to move out of the home. So,
I would like to add to both Anjali and Nasya. You know, one of the things as an agency, I feel, maybe a flag bearer for the trade, I feel, you know, people have been locked down for so long. I mean, 60, 70 days. People are so eager to go out. I mean, if you do some kind of a social listening, or if you look at, we've done some kind of research and all, people are egging out to go. So one is Out of Home is going to be the best place to be. And I feel for both the brands, Mondelez being a very mass national brand and IKEA being a very local Hyderabad based currently brand, both need that kind of a support, because there is going to be a dent in the brand recall. And I think if they start early, it will be the best place to be. To take that mileage, because ultimately consumers have lost touch with the brand. And I feel as an opportunist, a lot of brands will try to also use this space immediately after the lockdown to build, you know, the top of mind recall as soon as possible. And, you know, I've seen so many people talking about, I'm missing my restaurant, or I want to go to a mall and shop and things like that. And hence I feel taking the this kind of a initiative where you are taking a front foot advantage and advertising in the Out of Home space wherever possible will definitely give both the brands a lot of mileage.
I will want to have your view also on this. So is it, when we talk about reboot, it is also the time for Out of Home to consider changing its placement, as in like now all most of the, so should Out of Home now mean out of my balcony, like somebody just mentioned. This is what Rishabh was talking right in the beginning, that this is the time for Mr. Srivastav and other media people to also consider that we need to shift out of door from highways and from airports, from bus stands to locate to the local areas. Because even if I would have the urge to go out, I may just go to 2 kilometers and just come back. because I want to be safe also. So, Mr. Srivastav, if you want to start with this, that are you already considering that you know we need to have new place, a new kind of plan for outdoor?
No, Nazia, I think this is too early to plan something like that.
Okay.
Because there are two situations. One is we are all anticipating there could be a vaccine for the COVID in the future. If not today, maybe after 2 months. So we are assuming that definitely sooner or later, maybe after 2 months, 3 months, there will be a vaccine to this problem. Once vaccine is there, life will be more or less normal. Secondly, typically in India, we have 735 districts, out of which 135 are in red zone.
Okay.
Almost 600 districts are 50-50, 295 in green zone and 305 in orange zone. So, very large part of India is still not under so much of threat from COVID.
But when you talk of economics, the red zone is the...
Yeah,
I'll come
to that point, because the situation is so horrible because Mumbai and Delhi, which are the driver of the economy in the country, these two places are suffering from COVID. So that is where the problem is happening, and to a great extent even Chennai is suffering very badly. Except Bangalore, and Bangalore is one place which is comparatively not so much under threat from COVID. But because of Mumbai and Delhi, the popular impression going to most of the clients or to the people or the masses is that, oh my God, everything is coming to an end. But actually, it is not so. I mean, we have seen a lot of movement. The moment the government decided to allow the traffic movement, they decided to unlock. So much of movement of people was there. I mean, see the restaurants. I mean, my Bangalore office was telling me, once the malls are opened there, even restaurants, you can see a lot of people were eating out and sitting inside restaurants, and they are roaming around in the malls also. So people are desperate to come back out of their home. So I don't think
in Delhi the decision has bounced back. No, it has led to
an extent, but Nalia, COVID is spreading in certain pockets only. It's not spread across. Wherever you see the containment zones are restricted to some pockets. It's not even in Mumbai, even in Delhi. There are pockets where so many cases are being reported. It is not set across. And gradually things are coming to see the when the air traffic was started, how people were hesitant. When I started my office 1 month back, we were so hesitant to come to the office. But in 1 month's time, I can see almost more than 50% people are comfortably coming. Though we have allowed, don't come to the office, work from home, but then they are comfortable. I mean, people have accepted that COVID is going to be the part of life. At least
maybe
for
they're more comfortable in office than home.
Yeah.
Mr. Mehta, would you want to add? Your mic is off.
Sorry, yes. So COVID is definitely here for some time. So we'll just have to live with the new norms and live with the fact that it's going to be there, because we really don't know whether the vaccine will come out in 2 months or not. And if at all it comes out, whether all of us will get it, how effective that's going to be. So I think with all those factors in mind, it's important that we have a change in mindset and we go with the fact that it's here now. And this is the new normal, and this is how we are going to moving forward.
So what are the solutions that we can look at?
So I think, as Anisha rightly said, we definitely have to look at a much more integrated format and not just out of home per se, the traditional out of home billboards, but looking at various touch points where we can get the consumer and engage the consumer, whether it's the consumer stepping out of the house and interacting with the interactive kiosk there, or going to say a retail store to buy their vegetables, etc. at that point, or if they're going to their office, then maybe the COVID digital kiosk that have just come up now in the market, those. So all those points are now, I think, very relevant. It's very important to keep engaging in an integrated way and focus more on using technology and content. I think now is the time to really engage a lot of the smaller brands who've not had the budgets to really play out on out of home. I think this is the ideal time for any of the brands to come up and get a larger voice of share in the overall marketing mix and use this opportunity to do outdoor integrated campaigns where they'll get a lot of value moving forward. And there are a couple of brands we are working with right now, and they've really picked up on this, and we see the big difference in terms of their approach, in terms of looking at out-of-home now, not only purely from the billboard perspective, but as a integrated various touchpoint perspective. And it's, I think that's here to stay. That will really change the way moving forward for all brands.
Mr. Naik, you would want to add to it. Do you agree that we need to reboot in the sense that we need to change the locations, we need to approach it differently?
I think as you know, sometime back Anisha said, you know, it's very, very important to reinvent. And you know, as the true custodian of the industry, I think we should. And I think sometime back Rishabh also mentioned about, you know, the society, digital screens and all. So people have really in this situation also, a lot of them have reinvented. I also know of a couple of agencies who have tied up with shopping malls where grocery stores and all, and did a combined branding. So where they've done some kind of activation. So I truly believe that COVID, I think, is going to be there for 2-3 months. And if you have to survive, you will have to reinvent. And there are so many other opportunities where, you know, we as brand custodians, between Anjali and Anisha also.
Can you define reinvent? Like, what exactly can brands do with the outdoor space?
So obviously, traditional out-of-home is there. There is a lot of corporate branding which is available, because you will see, as Atul said, people are coming to office. Our office is also open, obviously with a lot of restriction and safety and all. So corporate areas are there. There are grocery stores which are available for branding. There are societies which are available. So a lot of going beyond billboard is one of the media options, but also, we need to keep into mind that everyone has hit financially, be it brands or be it agencies or be it our media partners. Everyone is going to reach the red line or cross the red line. And to avoid that, I think brands would be looking at reinventing and looking at optimized solution, whether you can get data in and around optimizing the planning capabilities or buying capabilities. There are going to be negotiations. So I think reinventing both sides, both in terms of media, but also in terms of our planning capabilities. How do we plan? How do we optimize our spends? Because optimization is going to be the new normal for all of us. And which is where, fusion of so many new industry standards have come into play. Europe is changing in terms of its media currency or media measurements. US is changing. We've been doing it for last couple of years where we've integrated mobile data in our out-of-home planning. So a lot of new initiatives are available for agencies, media partners, as well as brands to reinvent holistically, not in terms of only whether to take billboard or not to take billboard, but I think holistically everyone will have to reinvent their own self looking at the out-of-home domain.
Jayesh, if you can quickly answer this, because I already have 20 questions and we are already midway.
Sure, Naja. I'll quickly touch upon this thing. The changes kind of changes what it is required. What I would feel that I would divide it into three major things, which is like first would be the client first kind of approach, where the new thing would be the emphasis would be on a more of a solution provider rather than a service provider. You have to go to the client with the solution on the objective or the problem what they are facing, rather than going along with your services, what you have to offer. if you have something which is a solution-driven solution provider, wherein you can help the brand in terms of their sales, you can help the brand in terms of their branding, or in whichever way, whatever the weak point brand has, if you can help them with the solution, that will be the new thing, while brand will immediately able to buy outdoor in. Second would be adaptability. When I talk about the adaptability, it's like, you know, we have to adapt ourselves to the new normal, what we are talking about. So the consumer is going to behave in a very, very different way. And the new touch points, the new time span, how, where, what is going to be the crucial thing. So adaptability has to be very, very fast and effective way. Solution provider is one of the thing which will be required in this. And third would be empathy. When I say about empathy, empathy is like empathize with your own people, being together in this difficult time and assuring of the best always. If you inbuilt this kind of a thing in them, they will come out with a solution which will be able to help you increase your business. So basically unlock 2.0, what we are talking about, I would say solution, adaptability, and empathy.
I've got two more questions in the meantime that you were giving me the answer. So I'll quickly take questions. I'll try to address it to one panelist at a time so that we can take as many questions as possible. If I can start with Mr. Srivastav, because I think you can answer this the best. Is it the right time to invest in outdoor properties as all corporations are ready to offer sites at negotiable rates?
No, it is not true. They are not offering at any negotiable rate. Definitely, the subject of today's discussion, the reboot. In my opinion, this reboot is going to happen mainly in terms of the rates of the media, in terms of the expenses which organizations had already overcommitted. So that kind of rebooting is going to happen. But definitely, this is a good time to acquire media, because people will be very, very cautious while quoting for any new tender. So definitely a very reasonable. Some time back we could see one could go to any extent. Matlab ye tender lena hai to at whatever price. I mean something where X person is quoting say rupees 100, somebody else can quote 200 rupees also. So there was no sanctity of the rates. Whosoever wanted to take a particular tender, then irrespective of the rate or the cost, they were going super aggressive. And ultimately the industry was suffering for that. And people, media owners were also suffering for that. Now that sense is there. Everybody has realized, boss, there is a limit to money which we have. Let's spend it very carefully. So I am very sure whatever tenders, whatever new acquisitions happen, will be at a very, very reasonable rate.
Next question, the person has addressed it to Anjali. What are your expectations from your agency which will convince you to invest again in out-of-home? Data and strategy is by default. Apart from that, what are other factors that will influence your decision?
Return investment for sure. We look at all our investments from the perspective of what it is going to do for business on our brands. And all our advertising is, of course, targeted towards making sure that we are reaching the consumer and connecting with the consumer. So whenever we have an appropriate occasion or an appropriate campaign, and if the agency can think of a great media plan, then definitely we would look at considering.
Next question also you can answer. Will you continue to work with your agency? Or will you be open, I don't know who has sent this, or will you be open to the idea of working with another agency if the other agency has a better idea for your brand? Can skip that.
Please not. So for us, our agency is actually our extended, I would say, team. We don't consider them as agency at all. They are our partners on our
business. I think you can conveniently skip that question. We can move to the next question. So this question, Harish, maybe you can start with. What needs to be rebooted in outdoor? The offerings, kind of media, price points, innovations, locations, type of media?
I think you have to look at what are the things you can immediately change and what are the things will take time to change. So obviously, the you know, changing the entire media dynamics is going to be very, very difficult, you know, soon. But obviously, things, you know, where we can look at strategizing it better, bringing it, bringing in a lot of data points into the business, because we need to help our clients take right decisions. And as Anjali said, as a media partner to my client, am I able to bring that ROI, and am I able to answer that question and help my client connect its brand and its consumer, then I'm answering the question. So I think a lot of focus has to be there. Obviously, initiatives which we've been talking for a very long time, in terms of, if you look at, for me, out of home has always been a medium which defines the city. I mean, why do you go to a Times Square or a Piccadilly Circus or a Osaka Circle? Is basically you go there to see large format billboards. A city looks beautiful if you have good properties. And I think government should, in this reboot mode, look at, you know, taking the initiative and supporting the industry by relooking at the touch points and also the quality of the medium. If the quality of mediums improve, I think it will be beneficial to everyone, both to our clients and their brands, because they will have a good exposure for the brand. The hygiene levels across will be better. So I think overall, we need to look at various points, but obviously the focus has to be how much we can change as soon as possible. Things which we can change very fast, we should definitely look at changing and reinventing.
So I'm trying to club the questions. A lot of people are repeatedly asking what something that Anisha also mentioned. Is it time for outdoor to go hyper-local? Rishabh, would you want to take that question?
Yes, for sure. We've already seen that has started playing out over the last, just before the COVID era as well. Brands are already looking at hyperlocal solutions and looking at getting greater ROI with that, because it makes more sense to do it at places which where you have your maximum audience profile, rather than just painting the town red with all the possible billboards that you could get or touch points that you could get. So definitely is hyperlocal is the way forward. And I think we'll see more and more integrated solutions where you see a combination of billboard and a digital and mobile all going together at hyperlocal level.
Jayesh, you want to add to it? Do you also agree?
I would say outdoor is all about hyper-local from beginning. I don't know why it is say that it's time for outdoor.
But to now we are even more localized, you know. So it is become subjective now.
Yeah, I mean, see, outdoor is, we have been always using it. I mean, all over, or even if it is a bigger brand. I'll give you just an example, like say a bank. A bank is a large-scale national bank. When they have a campaign regarding the brand or something, they would do a national campaign. But whenever they are keep opening a branch, it's a hyper-local thing which runs around for years. I have been dealing with three of the banks everywhere. So in a small district of West Bengal, you open a branch, you would do campaign in the two or three peripheral, you know, that kind of a radius, wherein you want people to walk into the branch from that area only. When you do for QSR, like say McDonald's, you know, wherever the shop is opening, you are doing that. So hyperlocal is the best example outdoor could work. And, you know, no media can take alternate on this. You cannot go to press, you cannot go to television, you cannot even go to radio as far as the kind of minute level hyperlocal outdoor can go. So outdoor has always been hyperlocal. It has been using in a great manner. There is no alternate to outdoor as far as hyperlocal.
But is this all the more time to go hyperlocal?
I mean, it's icing on the cake, I would say. You know, it's already we are doing it, and time is more. You know, one could even go. It's good for the even tier two, tier three kind of cities as well, where most of the corporate brand and all are, you know, restricting themselves to top 10, 12, 14 kind of cities. With going hyper local, I think those cities will see kind of tractions as well.
Anisha, you want to add anything to that? Because you used that a lot in Hyderabad, right? Your mic is off. Anisha,
sorry. Yes, absolutely. And as Jayesh, he's already spoken the point that I was going to say, that it is, Out of Home has always been about being hyper-local. Geo-targeting, segmentation gets us the right kind of people, the relevant people who we want to talk to. With us, it's a very simple example. When we launched e-commerce in Mumbai, we didn't launch to all the pin codes. And at that point of time, the activity that we did was we picked up railway stations. Which is the mode of transport and across the city, and we actually clustered them in a way that wherever the service was launched. So indirectly, directly, it is doing segmenting basis areas. Now in digital terms, we do a lot of profiling, psychographics, demographics. You take all of those terms in there. In terms of out of home, the parameters are slightly different, but at every level we do hyperlocal. At the same time, it also depends on what stage your brand is at and what is it at that point of time that your brand wants to do. So for when IKEA launched in Hyderabad, our aim was to spread out the word.
But those are very different times.
Exactly.
We are talking about post-COVID times.
Right now? Yes. I can't have thousands of people coming to my store every day. We did have it at some point of time, but I want people to buy online. When I want to do that, I will obviously reach out to those areas where they've been doing maximum shopping. And I will do a hyperlocal targeting for that. So the times are changing. The modes are just being
used. And you can use Outdoor for that.
Absolutely. Why not?
Yeah. I just want to add to
the reinventing caveat.
Yeah. Just to add to Anisha, I think I only have a deviation to what you said, is just the way you do hyperlocal targeting in digital. Even in out of home, you can use shapefiles at pin code level. You can integrate data, and you can also integrate your sales data to a pin code and do the planning. So that kind of hyper local targeting is also possible in the out of home space.
Absolutely, Haresh. You know, it's just that measurability has always been a debate when it comes to something that we spend the most money on. And, you know, there are tools and equipments and a lot of tools which have now been devised to do that. But how many brands are really using it? How equipped are we to really, you know, live by those numbers, that how many eyeballs am I gauging at every signal that we have? So it's a debatable thing. We need to just bring it up as strongly as performance marketing in e-commerce, just for example. Yeah.
But performance marketing in the out-of-home space is there to play today. I mean, you can create your own channels where your sites are there. You can put your polygons and you can measure the audiences which are passing your billboard. So that is easily possible today. And a lot of brands today, fortunately, are using and integrating a lot of data points, right from the store location to even getting into sales data and various other data which can be integrated and an optimized plan can be worked out. So I think the only thing is, I mean, both the digital as well as the out-of-home space, benefit of technology, both the spaces are becoming very, very close. So I think those benefits are available in the out-of-home space also today.
Jayesh, I saw a very big smile on your face when the topic of measurability came in. So would you want to say something on that? Measurability has been a problem without.
Yeah, Elvin, that's the reason very big smile was there. And it's been years we have been talking about. Everyone has measurability. All the
time. Everyone on the group is smiling here on this topic.
Yeah, because it's been quite some time people have been talking about. It's not now. It's been, for me at least, it's been 20 years in this industry. And I'm seeing from day one, people have been talking about this. I don't know. Unfortunately, we have not been able to come together and come up with a syndicated data or a numbers as far as measurability is concerned. But having said that, there are people who are having this on an individual level, like Haresh was mentioning some time back, that there are possibilities. There are possibilities of marrying digital with outdoor, like earlier radio with outdoor, how it used to happen. Now it's happening with digital. There is a possibility of retargeting. There is a possibility of hyperlocal. There is a possibility of somebody has seen the billboard and, you know, you could check whether that guy has actually, the walk-in happened to your store or not. Polygon mapping, data centric. There are a number of things which are happening. And all the top agencies have this data. It's not that I have and somebody doesn't have it. All top agencies have their data in their own limitation or in their own this thing. The only thing which is lacking is a syndicated number. Unless and until we have a syndicated number or a currency, it will be very difficult for you know, Anjali and Anisha to believe, whom to believe rather, you know, because everyone comes up with the thing and everyone demonstrates that thing. So it is a need of an hour, no doubt about it. It is definitely a need of an hour, and sooner the better.
I want to take at least three more questions from the audiences. One, if I can start with Mr. Srivastav. Outdoor is considered an expensive medium to advertise as compared to digital. Do you think the reinvention will also look at cost control even post-economic drop? How are we approaching the ROI metric to compete with digital?
Outdoor is not that expensive, definitely. When you talk about outdoor and its cost, outdoor media is costly in metros, maybe in Mumbai, Delhi, Bangalore. But typically in all tier 2, tier 3 cities, outdoor is very, very reasonably priced. Definitely after this kind of rebooting and this cost cutting and all these things will happen after this reboot, you can call it. Cost is going to come down. It has already started coming down. We are already getting discounts from media owners. We are also a media owner. We are also offering discounts on the media because the need of the hour is to ensure occupancy. So definitely cost is going to come down in the next 2 to 3 months time. But I don't actually subscribe to the fact that outdoor is an expensive medium. It is expensive compared to what? When you are comparing it.
Talk about digital. They're comparing it. He's comparing it. He's specifically asked when you compare digital, it to digital.
Digital and outdoor, out-of-home media have two different functions.
And we're digital has emerged as, you know, as a hero in these last few months. So, yeah. And most of your inventory has, I think, gone into digital.
Digital definitely is growing because there is a surety whenever the number of clicks are there. You know how many people have actually visited, but typically you should try and recall how many times you have to skip ads. I mean, ad will display whether you are watching YouTube or something, how frequently you did press that button of skip ad. And digital has never built any brand, although Laksh has a digital marketing vertical also, which is doing pretty well. So I'm not opposing to that, but outdoor as a typical function, it is the brand building. The impact. It is not only just the impact which outdoor creates, it also ensures the reach. Like typically when a political campaign is happening, you will see the ideal combination of both. You will find a very stunning billboard of maybe the Prime Minister and it can be taken to maybe a Sector 21 of Kharghar also. So that outdoor can deliver you impact as well as the penetration, I mean the reach. So that is a typical function of outdoor, and there is a limit to the size of outdoor. Suppose Mumbai has 1,000 billboards. It cannot be increased overnight. When the season time comes, I cannot make it 1,200. I cannot make it 1,500. Whereas that can happen in digital medium. Whatever number of bookings Google receives or other players they receive, they can accommodate all those advertisements. But outdoor has got its own size.
Space is not a constraint.
Space, yes.
Rishabh, you want to add to it? Your mic is off.
Sorry. I think he's very right in saying outdoor has its own space. So obviously the impact that outdoor creates, the other mediums don't. So it's not a question of one is better than the other, but it's about having an integrated approach. Digital will definitely play a larger role moving forward because it just gives advertisers the additional freedom of engaging with the consumers in a more interactive manner. And that, which is not the case in the traditional billboards, but each medium has its own merits and demerits. I think moving together is the only way forward, and digital definitely will increase. Because as he likely said, it's easier to increase the digital footprints than to overnight increase the number of billboards in a particular city. So that will definitely happen.
We have 6 minutes left and I want to take up this question, which is one of the most difficult questions of this year. How much top line depletion do you see in financial year 2021 as compared to last year? Harish, if you want to start with it.
What our estimates are anywhere between roughly around about 20%, 15 to 20%, because we are also aligning monsoon to it. And if you look at all the agencies and the entire market, festive season contributes to around about 50-60% of our billing. So we estimate around about 15-20% of loss of business.
Jayesh, you want to add?
I would say that quarter one is virtually wiped off. April, May and June, it's kind of, June some traction is happening. April, May has been kind of wiped off. So quarter one is gone. Quarter two, the things are improving. We are debating and discussing the same. And I'm quite happy that, you know, there are a lot of things which are happening around, which I was not aware of. So overall, the traction is there in the industry. And Q2, we should definitely see, if not more than at least to the 50% of what Q2 was last year. I'm being very, very conservative when I'm throwing this number. But I recollect what Atul started with saying, Diwali season, where the Q3 comes into the picture, and Q4 with JFM, where BFSI gets quite active. I would say we are going to see more than 100% of what we did last year. So overall, I think if you sum this up, it more or less come to the figure what Harish said. So yes, you know, Q1 and Q2 is large, but the large part of business in out of home is always lies in Q3 and Q4. And hence we are seeing better Q3 and Q4, and hence the overall
losses
or whatever you want to put it as, or a less profit rather, I'll put it as, is that much.
Mr. Srivastav?
Yeah, typically it will be around 20%, could be 22-24%, or could be 15-17%. But around 20% of the top line losses we can clearly see. And let's wait and watch how the forthcoming months go. But as of now, yes, like Jayesh mentioned, the quarter one is completely washed out. And typically we normally generate 20-25% of billing, top line billing in this quarter, which we have lost. So I'm assuming the 20% top line losses will be there in this financial year.
Anjali, would you want to make any closing comment?
I would say Anjali and Anisha could help you to minimize the losses as far as possible.
Agree to that.
I definitely think we will bounce back in terms of business. I think the bigger challenge for the out-of-home industry is how do you create consumer experiences now that, you know, you're in this new environment. And I'm saying this more from the perspective of brands like ours, where we don't just do out of home is just not a billboard for us, but it's also about, you know, installations and kiosks and things like that, where we have the opportunity for our consumers to interact with our brands. And that, I think, is something that they will have to think through. Otherwise, I think business as normal will come back surely by the time festive season is around the corner.
Anisha?
I think, yes, I don't see depletion really, but all I see is there's a change in human behavior. And every consumer who's here is a human first. And, you know, how do we look at the human aspect and then look at building the channel will be the most important thing. Then come whether it's the August sale or whether it's Diwali or it's New Year, everything will work out. If we are talking to people in the language that they want to hear, if we are not too pushy, if we are not becoming the opportunist that we all may tend to become as business people. We all have running businesses, but what will be most impactful and will keep us in the race will be to bring that human factor, because this is really, this can't get more real. So, and trust is something that will be built only over a period of time. So let's be less pushy, let's be human first, and let's talk what people really want to hear from us. Then everything will work out. The moment we'll become pushy, we'll be the opportunist and we'll be sidelined. I'll just take one example there, biology. I just read about it 4 days back, and last, I think, 85 years, oh, they've got the highest revenue ever. Not just because they're an FMCG brand and then they were distributed in every railway station and every SKU possible, but because they kept up with what they say and what they do. It's just a small example. Mondelez, for example, is another great example on how they've been surviving. So FMCG brands have really been doing well. But you see, any of these brands, whatever channels they've chosen in the last few months, they are talking absolutely purpose-led communication. They're absolutely talking what is the need of the hour. What we are talking on our website, on our platforms, is home is the place with possibilities. We're talking home. We do want people to buy, but we can't say that right now, and we would never do that because that's where people are showing the interest in. So let's figure out and do a little more maybe research in terms of where are people mobilizing, what are they choosing, what do they want to read about, what do they want to see outside, and then the channel mix will automatically develop, and that's when we'll make the package, and our agencies will obviously give us the right media plan then.
Rishabh, sum it up in a minute. We are already out of time. Sure. Whatever you want to, your closing remarks.
So I think for us as a technology media solution provider, to be honest, this has been a positive happening. That's because it just moved everybody at a faster pace in terms of adoption of technology and going digital. We face issues with the immediate burning issues with our partners here, with the kind of business that has gone out. But I think moving forward this year, we hope to, in fact, end the year with a way higher top line than what we did last year as well, because purely everybody is moving towards adopting technology. So we're really going at a much more faster pace, and we're also going in other markets where things are really looking very bright. So for us, thankfully, it's been a silver lining so far, and we hope with all the other stakeholders.
We wanted to talk about digital outdoor, programmatic outdoor, but we're completely out of time, and I've already got like 46 questions. I think take up 4 or 5 questions. Maybe we should have another webinar with all of you guys whenever you are available.
If you allow me, can I?
I am coming to each one of you. I can have your closing remarks before.
Sure, sure. What I wanted to say, it's for any kind of a marketeer, it's very easy to say that to cut the marketing spends and we'll come back when the things bounces back or when the things gets back to normal. However, I would like to say that brand building is not done with a switch off of button. It is not an on or a off kind of a thing wherein you switch it on or a switch it off. All leading brands have 360 degree communication going at any point of given time. Yes, there will be a skew towards a particular media which changes with the time. Right now, the skew towards outdoor was zero. Now the skew towards outdoor is increasing. But, when I would like to say that outdoor is something, the one major media, because one cannot go away with it because of its ability to make a statement which is larger than life, which you cannot do. This is one of the only media which you cannot avoid or ignore. You can change your channel, you can decide to switch off your mobile, you can do anything. But if you are on road and driving and billboard is right in front of you,
You can change your route.
You cannot. There will be billboards on those routes as well. Once you cannot ignore it, its ability to make a statement which is larger than life, being hyperlocal in nature, which is again uncomparable, which we have seen, reach to the last mile. When the customer is actually walking into a store or a dealership or anything else, the last point of communication just before the point of sale is going to be outdoor. It's high penetration. These are just to name a few, advantages which is there. So it is definitely going to be in congestion with the large, high-reach media like television to an extent. Print, digital, of course, we have discussed quite a bit. So it is definitely going to be. But outdoor will be one of the, you know, one of the major communication channel for the large brands going forward. One cannot just ignore it just because of the COVID thing is what I wanted to say.
Harish.
Yeah. So my closing remarks, I mean, it's an honor and thank you for having me on the webinar. And it was great interacting with all of them and sharing the platform. And there was a great learning. I feel if I want to close it, I think positivity is very, very important for all of us. And, when we talk of positivity, it is important that we look at what are our controllable factors and non-controllable factors. COVID is a situation which is uncontrollable. So we should look at what is controllable and we should work on our strengths. And I think it is very, very important that we should have the self-belief. And it is very important right now going forward is to reinvent overall our consumer connection as well as our service offering to our clients and, come back to them with a solution which is right to the audience. And I feel, we worked with Anjali on the Tang activity some time back and it got a lot of appreciation. And, we are very proud that in such a moment we were able to pull it off. Just that if we had thought that it was not possible, we could have not pulled it off. So I think belief is very, very important. And I think out of home, definitely, as Jayesh said, it does not have an ad skip or an ad block. And it's a medium where everyone will go for. So I think let's stay positive and let's work towards getting it back to normal. So those are my closing comments. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Srivastav.
Thanks, Nazia, for this beautiful session, and thanks to Exchange for Media Group also. In my closing remark, all I would like to say is I have a great faith in the market of this country. I mean, irrespective of whether COVID continues for next 6 months also, I still feel people will have their needs and their marketing requirements. They are going to go to the market. As it is, they have started accepting the boss, whether COVID or not, no COVID, we are going to fulfill our needs, whether it is related to travel or to some extent even related to their tourism, which is very, very challenging thing at this point of time. So when it comes to their buying habits, their shopping thing, definitely they are going to all out. And the potential of this country, the population of this country has tremendous potential. And marketers will have to sell their brand, and to sell, they will need to advertise. And if they have to advertise, then outdoor is going to be one very good and viable option. So I am very, very confident about out of home and its future. Country is going to have its market back very soon. Whether COVID is there or it is not there, after 2-3 months, market will be back with full bang, and outdoor will have its rosy days again. Thank you very much.
We sincerely wish everything that you say comes true. I had requested you all for max 10 minutes more, so we are in time. It's 5:08. I have no closing remarks because somebody has already, one of the viewers has already sent a message. Bhumi Lakhani has said, this is one of the most positive and optimistic webinar in last few months that I have seen. Kudos to all the panelists. So thank you all for joining us. I think we should also thank Priyanka for putting up this interesting panel and having all of you here. And Bhumi has also said that we should have this more. So, we may come back to you again for another webinar. And there's so many points that we wanted to cover, but we couldn't cover because and we're already out of time. So thank you, each one of you, for joining us. We sincerely wish that the market bounces back and we're all back on track and we're all back on roads and all the outdoor billboards are full of ads again. Thank you so much for joining. Thanks.
Thank you, Nazia. Thank you, Priyanka. Thank you. And thank you, Eva.
Stay at home, stay safe. No, go out.
Stay safe, take care.
Yeah.
Okay.
Stay safe.
All the best. Everyone. Thank you.
Everyone. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.